Priya, Nadez, Kopika and Thanaka, finally going home.
I have spoken to the family and wish them well for their return. This decision will allow them to get home to Bilo.
Today, the new Labour government granted them bridging visas to stay in the country while they wait for the girls' citizenship application to be approved.
We're just so excited that they're finally coming home, home to Bilo where they'll be safe, home to Bilo where they belong.
But the journey to get to this point has been long and torturous. In a 2018 Dawn raid, the Tamil family was seized from their home.
Everywhere, police, but I don't know why come to my house.
Thrown into Melbourne detention, despite claiming to suffer persecution at the hands of the Sri Lankan government. But our government never accepted that and denied them refugee status.
I don't sleep in the night time. It's very, very hard. It's no happy. I'm thinking it's lots.
A year later, the family is again subjected to a traumatic surprise raid. Border force officials, this time intent on deportation. But a mid-air injunction thwarts the move. The family instead sent to Christmas Island, where they languish for almost 2 years, where four-year-old Thanaka's health takes a serious turn.
The youngest daughter of the Biloela family is in the process of being medically evacuated.
It is now believed she has a blood infection caused by untreated pneumonia.
Flown off Christmas Island for a medical emergency.
The family eventually allowed to live in community detention. Their fate dragged out in the courts, the government adamant it's following procedure.
This family knew the terms of the arrangement with Australia.
Well, that wouldn't be government policy for a pathway to permanent settlement. That is not the government's policy.
Today, one family's nightmare finally coming to an end.
We really honour and respect that this is their time to take back the story of their lives. So we are going to stand with them every step of the way to support them to do that.
Well, Bronwyn Dendall is part of the Home to Bilo campaign, who've been fighting to bring Priya, Nadez and the girls home for 4 years. And I'm pleased to say that she joins us now. Bronwyn, I know that the announcement was expected today, but what was that moment actually like when it became official?
It was almost surreal, to be honest. You know, after hoping and praying and asking for 4 long years, it was almost surreal to know that today, finally, it was announced that they're going to be able to come home to Bilo.
Have you spoken to Nadez and Priya, the parents?
Yeah, they're so relieved and so grateful that they're finally going to be able to come home.
So do you think it's really sunk in for them, the reality of this?
To be honest, I think it'll probably sink in for all of us once their feet are on the ground here in Biloela. I think then it'll really feel real when they're back where they belong.
Where is their process at now? Because they're on bridging visas. Does that mean that it is actually all over for them?
No, it just means there's a few more steps in the process to go. So a bridging visa gets them home, and that's the main thing. That's what we're most excited about. You know, this is Tani's first visa, actually. So that bridging visa gets them home, and then they sort of start stepping through the processes, you know, to sort of make sure that they have that certainty moving forward and that they stay safe here in Australia in Bilo.
Bronwyn, I know sometimes when people get caught up in Australia's immigration system, things go wrong. Can you just give everyone some insight into what this has been like?
Yeah, it's been interesting because those of us who have, you know, continued to stand up when others might have chosen to sit down, I suppose, for want of a better description, there have been risks we've taken to stand up and, you know, fight for this little family to come home. But certainly there have been times where, you know, because of, you know, the spin that, you know, that the previous government would put on things and things they would say about the family and the case, there have been people that became too afraid to speak up. But I think maybe, you know, last weekend, you know, was proof that Australia, you know, values compassion and humanity, and moving forward, more people will stand up.
So tell us, what's on the cards for their homecoming and when will that be?
Yes, we're all eagerly awaiting that. It'll be early June, we're thinking, at this stage. And so that's looking good to have them home in time for the Biloela Flourish Festival, which is the 11th of June. And that's an annual festival we have that celebrates the diversity of this beautiful community. So they are very much a part of that. And the story that this community stood up for their mates is a part of what helps us flourish as well. And then just after that is Tani's fifth birthday. And she has had every birthday in her lifetime in detention. So this will be her first one free and in Bilo, home where she belongs.
Well, here's to happy times ahead. Bronwyn, thanks so much for speaking with us.
Thanks so much.